Welcome, people of the internet. My name is Talent, and today, guys, I'm going to be discussing if Super 7 is ripping you off. What I mean by that is, when I was looking back through all of my comments on my Super 7 Godzilla Minus One review, I saw a lot of the comments were distasteful of the figure. So let me show you some of the comments that I found. Before I get into the comments, I want to thank Kaiju Canuck for correcting me in my video. In December 23, Kyle Wadiga said that they were experimenting with movable jaws. And the Super Kaiju line will have them, and they're only exclusive to Target. So I just want to correct my mistake on that. I forgot that Kyle Wadiga said that. So without further ado, let's get into these comments. So the first one I want to get into is the one below Kaiju Canuck's comment. It says, I wanted with all my heart to have the nice matte finish they showed in the renders. But deep down, I think I knew it wouldn't. Such a shame. This could have been a huge win for them. So what this comment is essentially saying that like he doesn't like the matte finish on this figure. I do have it right here. Don't worry. And then another commenter said, he's glossier than I anticipated, but I'm still pleased with the final result. Hopefully Big Bad Toyster doesn't take too long to send mine. So with these two comments, it seems like they don't like the glossiness. And then also I saw this other comment below mine after it says it's still a win for Super 7. That guy said, it's glossy on camera. This is an absolute win. So it's not just me saying that it's just glossy on camera. And then this other guy said, MarvinSign1999 said, most of the Ultimates line are too glossy, which cheapens the overall look of the figure. And let's face it, since Super 7 blew up, they've become a bit expensive. Wait, 1989, Radioactive Breath Goji ended up too glossy, which is why I held off on getting an X plus minus one figure. Unparalleled detail and the color is spot on. So it's just essentially saying like the figure is too glossy, which I don't think it is. In my opinion, it looks really good. This other commenter said, honestly, my biggest complaint is the paint job. Way too much yellow. His head and shoulders are not near enough on his legs. When the paint shouldn't be yellow, it should be more tan. And maybe it's just the lighting, I don't know. But yeah, that's my biggest complaint. So also the paint job. I will say, that's something I should have said in my review, is that like the paint job should have been more. That's on my part, that I did not say that in the review. But I think what's going on is solicitation photos versus final product. Let me just show you some of the solicitation photos. Here is the solicitation photos for Godzilla Minus One. The final product does not look like anything the solicitation photos promised. This thing looks really good compared to the final product. I don't know what went wrong. I'm not mad about the final product. I'm just saying, if you're gonna do solicitation photos that are this good, you should follow through with that. Because compared to the actual figure, I will say that like I do see people's complaints of it not looking like solicitation photos. So yeah, I do get that complaint. I do see that complaint is what I mean. Let's look at more comments. As I was saying about like people being mean about solicitation photos, this guy said, honestly, even though it's not as painted as the initial prototypes, I'm still happy with it. It's a decent enough price minus one that poses pretty damn well considering how little joints are compared to SHMA. And it's bigger than normal too. I do wonder what the minus color version is going to look like though. Go check out Kaiju Canuck's review on the minus one color version. Minus color version. Another commenter said, the glossy paint makes him look cheap and it's smaller than I thought. Glad I canceled. So it's appearing that most people are canceling their figure because of the paint. So in my opinion, the final verdict is that Super 7 is not ripping you off at all. They have good solicitation photos. They just need to essentially fulfill the solicitation photos, if that makes sense. I do think the main problem with Super 7 is that they make their figures too glossy, which is not a complaint I have, because this is only my first Super 7 figure. If they do like less glossy figures, I might be able to pick some up. It's just Super 7 figures look too glossy in some areas, in like some photos and videos. But that's just me though. You guys have your own opinions. Please leave your opinions down in the comments about this figure, any other Super 7 figure, and that's essentially all I have to say about this figure and final product versus solicitation photos. I hope you guys did enjoy this like little short video. Make sure you guys like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace!